Hi guys, this is Sabrina yet again. So I apologize. We were having a bit of some technical difficulties because we are trying to figure out how to do a Facebook Live with this super awesome presentation that we made. And technology beat me this time. So I just wanted to restart again. So I'm so sorry about that, but I will get this up very shortly. And then if you guys have any questions, I still would love for this to be interactive. So if you guys are watching it, please comment below. Say what age you are and where you're watching from. I really would love to absolutely hear it, and especially if you guys have any questions. I will try my hardest to go through and answer as many questions as I can, but it just may be after I post this. Technology. But anyway, I do want to dive into it because I want to talk about whales and how whales are mammals. Because it really is one of the most interesting aspects of whales, I think. However, I think I said that for pretty much all of my live streams. So there are more than 80 different types of whales, dolphins, and porpoises in the world. That's what kind of the names that we call these marine mammals, or the big fancy word, cetaceans. Can you guys say cetaceans? Yeah, it's kind of a hard, weird word. But like I said, scientists are able to classify these whales, dolphins, and porpoises into two different groups. So they have baleen whales, like I talked about on Monday. Remember, the baleen is what's in their mouth. Or there's toothed whales, which orcas or whales that have teeth, or dolphins that have teeth. So that breakdown helps scientists be able to figure out what they're looking at when they're studying these whales and dolphins and porpoises. Now, all of these marine mammals do live in the ocean. Makes sense. They don't really hang out in any fresh water or anything. And most of them like to eat fish. They have a favorite food usually. So, for example, southern resident orcas love Chinook salmon. That's their favorite food. I'm sure you guys have a favorite food too. I love mac and cheese. Do you guys like mac and cheese? It's my favorite food. Anyway, so while these whales are eating fish, the real question is, are they fish? That's what we'll talk about today. That's the mystery. So we're going to play a little game of can you guess the difference? So whales, dolphins, and porpoises are mammals, and historically people confuse them with fish. So the first thing is blood. What is the temperature of their blood? Now we have animals that are warm-blooded, which means that their blood is warm all day, every day, year-round, or there's animals that are cold-blooded. So think, are your guys' blood warm or is it cold? Well, as humans, we are warm-blooded. We are mammals. And whales, as you can see by the little temperature thing, the whales have warm blood while fish have cold blood. Another difference is in how they breathe. So mammals, like whales and dolphins, breathe air through their lungs, just like you and I. So if we take a deep breath, we are using our lungs, and that remember that whale uses that blowhole in the top of its head. Well, fish, they use their gills on their side of their bodies, and they are extracting air out of the water when they're swimming around. So just like you and I, remember we are mammals. If we were swimming around in a pool, we have to use our lungs. So we have to come up to the surface to breathe every so often. And the same is with whales as well. Remember, whales have to come up to the surface to breathe. Now, whales are also really, really good at holding their breath, so they can just have, since they just have much bigger lungs than you and I do, they can hold their breath for much, much longer. So the next difference is that mammals, or whales and dolphins, give birth to live young. However, fish, they mostly lay eggs. So whales and dolphins, when they give birth, it comes out and that whale is alive right there, and that mom gets to help the baby up to the surface to take its first breath, just like we did when we were born. However, fish, they lay eggs, such as that mermaid purse, they call it, or that little kind of egg sac that sharks or other skates use when they are giving birth to other sharks. So that again is just another difference. And mammals also give milk to their young. Just like you and I, we drank milk when we were a baby. Maybe if you have a baby sister or a baby brother, maybe you have even helped feed your younger sibling with the bottle and the milk. And we see it all the time with goats and cows and dogs and cats. Well, these whales also have to give milk to their young as well. However, they can't necessarily use a bottle, so they are just able to shoot the milk into the baby's mouth, and then they get their milk that they can eat to grow really big and really strong, just like we did. So, another difference is that mammals, when they are swimming, they move their tail up and down. Do you guys want to do it with me? So, if you go like this and kind of latch your thumbs together, it's like a whale's tail. So, they move their tail up and down when they're swimming along. However, fish, remember, fish go side to side. If you think about it, sharks and other fish, when they're swimming along, their tail moves left and right, whereas whales go up and down. So, can you tell now if a whale is a fish or a mammal? They're a mammal. So, those are just a few characteristics, I can never say that word, of mammals. And next time you're looking and you see a fish, maybe you can try and remember some of those characteristics of mammals. They have warm blood. They breathe air with their lungs, remember? They give birth to live young, and they move their tail up and down. Now, there's some other pretty cool characteristics that I want to talk about. Because whales and dolphins, like I said, they're mammals. This is just my fun little intro. Can you name another mammal? So, if you were sitting with your siblings, or maybe with your parents, or your grandma, or if you're even alone, well, you can talk to your dog, or your cat, or your pet, whatever. What is another mammal that you can think about? Well, we are. Again, like I was talking about, you and I are mammals just like whales and dolphins, something that we have in similarity with them. Now, another thing is, we share a very similar skeleton with whales. So, this is one of the coolest things ever because you can see a whale's skeleton and then you can see a person's skeleton. And then we can go through. So, ribs. As you can see, a whale has ribs and we also have ribs too. Can you feel where your ribs are? They're protecting our heart and our lungs, all the squishy organs inside. They have shoulder blades. Can we point to our shoulder blades? They help us move our arms, and whales use those too. They have a neck. So, just like we have a neck, whales also have a neck. An upper arm. Can you flex? Show your upper arm. Well, the bones that are in our upper arm, whales have them too. Lower arm, so right here, whales have those bones too. Fingers. Whales even have fingers. Inside their long pectoral flippers, they're called, as you can see, they actually have all the same bones that we have in our fingers. It's pretty crazy when you think about it. They are just actually missing a finger. They only have four fingers. They have a jaw, just like we do. Can you find your jaw? They have eye sockets because they have to be able to see too. However, their eye sockets are a bit different because they're on the side of their head. Most of them are. The bigger whales have eyes on the side. Dolphins and stuff have eyes in the front. They have a nose. So our nose is here. Where do you think a whale's nose is? Right here. So the whale's nose is actually on the top of its head, and it helps that whale be able to breathe much easier. All it has to do is stick the little bit of its head out of the water. And then it can breathe so much easier than if it had to stick its whole face out into the water. They have a spine, Just like we have a spine, it runs down the very back. And as you can see, a whale spine is very big. But do you notice one big difference? So what bones do we have that whales don't have? We have a pelvis. So if you right where our legs are about to start, that's called our pelvis bone. But legs. Whales no longer have legs. As you can see, we have legs. But at the time, long, long time ago, whales actually lived on land and they had legs. But over millions of years, the whales adapted. They went into the water and they found that they don't really need legs. And they were much better swimmers without the legs. So, what you see today, the whales just don't have the leg bones that we have in our body. Now, one last characteristic, and this is one of my favorite characteristics, is that whales actually have hair too. Now, mammals, they have hair. We have hair. There's a lot of hair on our body, really. And if you think about it, other mammals, such as goats and cows, cats, excuse me, dogs, they all have hair too. Now, if you look at a whale, though, it doesn't look like they have a lot of hair, does it? Well, they do have hair because they're a mammal. And if you look at the very little bumps, so that picture is of a whale's face, basically. It's what we call its rostrum. And that line that goes up and down, there's the bottom jaw and then there's the top jaw. So this whale is sticking its nose out just like that, basically, even though remember, the nose is on top of its head. So those little bumps are called tubercles. Can you say tubercles? Yeah, it's kind of a weird word, but basically, those little bumps have one single hair follicle. Basically, a hair follicle, it's like if one little tiny hair was just on that little bump. So as you can see that there's tons of bumps like that all over the whale's head and bottom of jaw. And that tubercle is very similar to a dog or a cat. They have whiskers too, and those hair follicles help the whale be able to sense its surroundings, kind of like a cat or a dog. Now, scientists don't know a whole bunch of stuff about it, but they estimate that maybe it could help with the whale as it's swimming down to its feeding ground or its mating ground. Maybe it helps change the temperature differences. We really don't know. And that's the really crazy part is that there's still so much we don't know about whales. However, that's pretty much most of my presentation. And so I just wanted to thank you guys for joining me. I hope you've learned some things, and I am so sorry about the internet crash that we had and ugh, technology. But I promise you that I will work harder and I will finally figure this out so that it will be fun and interactive and you guys can comment and talk along with me as well. So I just am trying to bring it back up a bit so you guys can see me. I hope you had a blast and I encourage you guys to check out our educational website that we have. So if you go to our website, which is just whales.org, and then you can search for educational resources, we have a whole page of some pretty cool worksheets. There's coloring pages, there's crosswords, there's word searches, and a whole section of other organizations that are doing some really cool things. Because I know today it's kind of a rough time right now. Some people are home for long periods of time. A lot of kids are stuck without something to do. So we want to try and help out as much as possible. We would love any feedback. So if you guys are like, I really want to learn about narwhals, well, I will start reading about narwhals so we can do a fun live stream about them. But let us know if you have anything that you think would be really, really cool to talk about. And for you kids watching or you adults, quiz each other. Say, hey, what are some characteristics of mammals? What is something that mammals have in common amongst all animals? Remember, whales have hair. Whales have the same bones except for us, except for What bones? Leg bones. So, again, my name is Sabrina. I am here at our North American office at Whale and Dolphin Conservation. Thank you so much for joining, and I'm so sorry about this, the technology problems we're having. But tune in on Thursday for another very kid-friendly presentation about different whale species. Who is the fastest swimmer? Who is the biggest animal in the world? Maybe some of you guys know that. Who has the biggest brain? Tune in on Thursday and we will talk about it. Bye!